Hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back with more blood, fresh supply. Last time, we explored some remote ice caverns, and now we have headed into the Land of the Haunting here, which is based off the 1963 film of the same name, which centers around a haunted house not unlike what we will be seeing in this level. So, this level is just a big, sprawling place here, and it's incredible. It's such a great level. There's a lot of places to go, a lot of things to do, and it's a lot of people's favorite level in the game. Rightfully so. I mean, it's so well designed, so atmospheric, and it's really one that a lot of people point out when talking about Episode 2. And I love this scene here with the moonlight in the sky there. But anyhow, we have a life seed here, which we'll save for later, and we need the skull key to get through that door to get into that part of the house. Now, with the jump boots, we could jump over the hedges here, but we're going to go this way, the intended way. And we come across a phantasm and a zombie here. The name Phantasm in and of itself is actually... That was weird. The jump boots started counting down again. I think that's only been happening when I've been fighting phantasms for some reason. But anyway, secret in here. Yeah, the name Phantasm in and of itself is actually a reference to the film Phantasm, which came out in 1979. And in that movie is a place called the Morningside Cemetery. And if you remember, back to the very first level of the game, we explored a place called the Morningside Cemetery, and right here you can see back there. There's the dagger key, and I love this effect, this shadow effect right here. So awesome. Anyhow, ooh, what's this thing? Tesla charge, huh? Well, I don't really see what we would need any of those for right now. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Anyway, let's get down here, and we'll have some bloated butcher barbecue. Or actually, on second thought, that would probably be some of the worst barbecue on planet Earth, so never mind. Let's... Ah, lovely. Blow those guys up instead, and we got some gargoyles here. Now, I'm gonna see if I can try and pull something off here. Come on down here. Oh! I don't know... I can't remember if I've shown this off yet, but... Come on now. You can do it, buddy. Burn. Yeah, there he goes. I can't remember if we've seen this in episode 1 already, or in a... I know we haven't seen it in this episode yet. But yeah, that was the animation for the burning gargoyle there, and there's his tattered corpse there. So, yeah, all these windows, we can't get into the house this way, so we must go this way into a hedge maze, which isn't hard. It's not a hard maze to navigate, as with every other maze we've seen thus far. It's just, it is a little spookier. We've got all these creepies wandering around here. But nothing really that we haven't seen. So we'll let that guy just go down there. And there's a Tommy gun back here. And, oh, I also want to thank you guys for pointing something out to me that an important bit of information that I forgot to bring up back when we were exploring the Overlooked Hotel. Nice. When I was talking about how the Overlooked Hotel was a reference to the Overlook Hotel from Stanley Kubrick's film The Shining, I left out the part where that movie was a film adaptation of Stephen King's novel The Shining. And so, yeah, it originally comes from Stephen King. And I just, for whatever reason, forgot to bring that up, even though I knew that. So thank you guys for reminding me of that. And here's the entrance to the house. But if we go all the way back here, there's actually something we missed. And I believe it's back this way. Yes. If we go all the way back to the beginning of the maze, just for reference point, go in, go all the way down, and crouch right about here, and press right about here on the hedges there, you get access to the only super secret of the episode. Yeah, it looks like we're in the attic of the house here. Pretty cool. But anyhow, yeah, taking the teleporter sets you at the end of the maze there. But yeah, supposedly there's supposed to be some humming sound that you hear near that wall that you're supposed to press. I've never heard it. I don't know if it's gone from fresh supply or what, but Yeah, just know that you have to crouch down and hit it to gain access to the secret. Anyhow, let's wipe our feet on the doormat here and ring the bell. That sounded like Caleb's yell there. Anyhow, let's go ahead and go in. Ugh, creepy voices, and oh, we get a phantasm to greet us here. I wonder, yeah. Speaking of the jump boots there, because I don't know. Yeah, back the video up, and you'll see. Yeah, I managed to catch the jump boots as they were, as the timer was going down there when we fought that first phantasm. I've noticed, I went back and watched old, videos from, previous videos of this, and I think it's the phantasms that cause the jump boots to count down there. Ooh, nice. Anyway, yeah, there's a secret behind the bookcase here. So yeah, I'm not sure what causes that, but yeah, if that's some kind of glitch, then I would be, I would love to know about it, because that way I can prevent it from happening in future levels here. I guess maybe it's when you get too close to them, I don't know, or when they fly, nice, when they fly through you or something. I'm not real sure. But I did notice that in other videos, is that it only happens when I'm fighting phantasms, because I swear I'm not hitting the key to activate them. Come on down, boys. Ooh, don't get too close. Remember, social distancing is still a thing. Anyway, these frickin' get out of here. Yeah. All right, so they're dead. And yeah, we're gonna step outside for a little bit here because we have to get the dagger key. And yeah, you can see, you probably know what's coming here. Oh, it just sunk. He just sunk right into the water. All right. And yeah, there's some body armor down here if you need it. But that's all that's out here. Oh, and something else I should bring up. You can push the some of the statues, the gargoyle statues, you can push them around and even poke them with the pitchfork and they'll bleed, which is actually a pretty funny thing, even though not all of them transform. But anyhow, with the dagger key, let's go in here into the kitchen. Let's go ahead and get this guy. There we go. All right, flares. We got some. We got the buzz saws hacking up some organs there, and we got another phantasm in the walk-in here. Whoop. Whoa. Yeah, die. There we go. Now this guy. This guy will get down like this. Yes, burn and die. Now we'll go in here and grab the fire key. Now, interesting thing is that when you kill that bloated butcher right there, he also drops a fire key. But after you've collected one, you can't collect the other. So, interesting stuff here. So let's go straight ahead and straight ahead again. And we end up in the library here, the study. Oh! And let's grab this guy. Why did that guy not catch fire? You know what? Yeah, go down. There we go. All right. And let's get the last two zombies here. Let them burn and die. There's one, two. All right. So right in here, in the fireplace, you don't get burned somehow. But you can open up the wall for some fire armor. And funny thing, you can actually tag this secret multiple times. As you can see here, the secret message keeps repeating itself, which I believe is also a glitch in the original DOS Blood, too. And speaking of secrets, here's another one. But, yeah, let's go ahead and jump across. Oh, and something I should also bring up on the subject of, on the subject of fact-checking here. I really have to thank you guys for doing that. I was talking about some music from the Doomwad Scythe last time. Oh, really? You don't want to go down? Well, there you go. Yeah, I was talking about music from the Doomwad Scythe, and it was brought to my attention. Oh, he got me. It was brought to my attention that that music did not originate in Scythe. It is actually from the game Castlevania 64. It's the Castle Center music. So yes, thank you again for pointing that out. Now, I'm just going to explore the downstairs hallways here, just to kind of make sure that we didn't miss anything. Because I think also... Ah, that's right. Let's go around... Wait a minute now. There's some doors that lead you in there. I want to go in the proper way here. Yes, right in here. Right in here. This takes you into the dining room, and I wanted to enter from this side because I think... I don't know. It takes a little bit of finagling to do. Yeah, there we go. The candles float over onto the table there. Really cool stuff. Yeah, here's the other side of the room. And right here, this just goes back into the organ grinder area. And we'll just grab up some ammo. Now, let's grab these, or this, I should say. Bundle of dynamite. Nice, got them all. And this hallway just leads right back into the beginning here, and we have not gone upstairs yet. So, yes, everything that we've seen thus far has been downstairs. This level's so non-linear, it's kind of difficult to point out where to go. But anyhow, guns akimbo with a secret. And let's go over here, outside, and I'm going to grab a remote detonator. Wake up the zombies, pardon me, fellas, and let's go back here, get all these guys woken up. Yes. Brains! And then these guys. Alrighty. And that should take care of... Yeah, that should take care of them. Just in time for us to grab the spider key. Whoa! Backed into something. Oh, zombie. Rid of this guy, that guy. Yep, there's another burned gargoyle there. Ooh, lovely, lovely, lovely. Anyway, right, let's see. If we go around here, we'll just light this guy up with some flares here, because we've got the ammo for it. Yeah, earlier I took out the gargoyles out here with the napalm launcher through this window. This whole outdoor area is connected to both of these windows of the house here. But before you leave, don't forget about this secret, because I have forgotten about it many a time. Right in here, super armor. And with that, we can go back into the house. And we'll just head back through this window here, down this way, and we will go up the stairs. I love that. I love how the stairs creak when you walk up them. Yeah, it's, I don't know, it's just so cool. Anyhow... ooh, spooky down there. Well, that's scary. We'll go another way. I'm scared. I don't want to go that way. anyhow, let's go in this room where we'll find something equally as scary. This big ugly here that we gotta get rid of. And there they go. They activated again. I don't know why they did that. But anyhow, maybe if I switch to, like, the med kit or something, it'll be fine. But anyway, yeah, nothing in here but that phantasm, and you drop a life seed. He'll drop a life seed and really cool transparent window, or transparent, it's kind of redundant, window there. There we go. And we get a trap. Did I get him? I guess I got him. Choking hands trap there. And we come around. Wow! Nice. And... usually there's a spider in here. A green spider. I don't know where he went, though. Yeah, I don't know. Anyhow. Secret, classic secret behind the spinning bookcase here. Spirit armor, voodoo doll, doctor's bag. Alright, and with the spider key, we'll go in here. We got some screaming ghosty boys here. Ah. And get away. Ah. Alright. So we come in here for the eye key, and we can step out onto the balcony out here for all kinds of detonators there. And with, yes, here's that hallway we skipped before. But with the eye key, what we can do is first grab that, but we can jump back down here, open this door, and go through here to the right, the eye key door, and drop down. And we're in the cellar here. We'll just get rid of these obstacles in our way. And I'll get these out. Walk right about here. And a bunch of rats and choking hands will emerge. So we can get rid of them all like that. There might be one more rat here. Two more. Bah, there we go. All right. And here's a little thing. Shooting the barrel will prevent you from going back up the way you came. So anyway, we'll go over here. Another phantasm. And as soon as I get done killing this guy... Yeah, okay, the timer on those things hasn't changed, so maybe, I don't know, maybe it's just a glitch with these guys? I ain't real sure. Anyhow, Skull Key. Shoot that barrel, and, you want to see something fun here? Jump down, wake these guys up, right? Ooh, all these big bad zombies, right? Well, they won't be so big bad anymore, because we have fire! So let's play with some fire. Yes. Just jump over their heads. Yeah. Shoot, let's give it one more. Yeah, let's give him one more. And that is how you have fun with the spray can. Yeah, all right, got them all. So, down at this end of the hallway, we can go up here and open this wall here, and this takes us back to that secret where we got the limited invisibility cloak. Uh-oh. Ah! Gotta go back. Dang it! Be right back. All right, so I actually had to noclip back in here just to be able to get back into this area because... if you destroy the barrel, like I was talking about earlier, you can't get into this area at all. So, that'll actually give me a chance to kind of show off something else about this game at the very end of this level. We'll just get this bloated butcher down here. Come on now, there he goes. Grab some flares. I wanted to show this off right here. If you hit this lever and open this door, you end up back in the dining room, which is where... I wanted to go originally, because it sets us a lot closer to where we need to go next, because we can go out these double doors here. This is the only way we have not gone yet. And we'll use some napalm here. Speaking of napalm, and just another thing, thing to add to the list of anachronisms in this game, napalm was not invented... or at least it wasn't an official weapon, an officially used weapon, until after World War II. But its earliest form was known as Greek fire, used by the Byzantine Empire in the year 672. But I say it's an anachronism because, and yes, see, we're right back here at the beginning of the level where we were before. But I say it's an anachronism because this game, the prologue of this game, takes place in 1871, and the main game takes place in 1928, and right here's the last secret with Beast Vision. We can lower this down. But, yeah, the reason I say that, and see, here's that life seed that we saved earlier, but I say that because, yeah, Caleb technically shouldn't be able to even use napalm as a weapon here. It shouldn't even be in this game. But, I mean, given the fact that this game has so many cultural references here... Oh, nice. Given that this game has so many, like, out of... like, you know, I guess... cultural references not, you know... like, not taking place in this game's timeline, or not have not even happened yet, then, you know, it's just another minor thing there. And another interesting little bit of information is that when sometimes, and he hasn't done it yet, but sometimes when Caleb picks up a napalm launcher, he'll say, "I love the smell of napalm in the morning," which of course is a reference to Apocalypse Now, but hopefully he'll say it here in a future level. And let's surface before we take any damage there. But yeah, just a little trivia on the history of napalm there. Anyway, let's go up here. those guys down. And stand back when you shoot those barrels. And with that, yes, this leads back to the pool that we drained. And right over here is our exit. All right. And see, this is another thing I wanted to show you guys here. Anytime you use a cheat code, the game will call you out for it. And then it's like, you cheated. But anyhow, 10 out of 8 secrets coming from, you know, that secret I tagged multiple times there. Anyhow, yeah, with everything, all secrets found, and our super secret in hand, we will go into the Cold Rush next. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.
Thank you.